So here we are in post-apocalyptic Castle Carey, and I think there are zombies around. And there is a particularly vicious zombie around who seems to be wielding a couple of weapons. So the first thing we need to do, because the zombies never use their legs for some reason, I don't know why. So the zombie's always going to come in, either wielding his hands or his face, or some kind of weaponry if they're advanced zombies. Yeah, so probably Walking Dead season 10 or something. So, okay, now the zombie's being a bit scary. So the zombie's going to come in and I'm going to try and keep my distance from him. The zombie's just gone to put a sheet mask on. Don't ask me why. So the zombie's going to come in, and the first thing we do, whether he's armed or not, is to keep him away from us. He can't get anywhere near us with his arms, because his arms are this long and legs are that long. So we can keep him away with front kicks or leg kicks, or if we're feeling brave, we can do a roundhouse kick like that. But if he gets too close, then we have to change our technique and start using hand techniques. So if he was to thrust with his knife, then we control the knife, break zombie's arm, break his leg, break his wrist, put him down on the floor, and yeah, basically run him through. And so that's a zombie attack, part one. And now we have control of the zombie's weapon, which is quite a fearsome blade, as you can see. So I can see him still dancing around, so I'm just going to finish him off here. And there we have it. And he's got up again, as zombies tend to. And take him out. And just for good measure, we just throw the dagger up and then his chest. And that, there you have it, viewers. But if the zombie gets really, really close, so too close for feet, too close for hands, then we're going to start using shorter appendages. So we start using knees and elbows and maybe your palm or your head or anything like that. And again, you can swipe it onto the ground and finish him off.
Are you going to show a person like myself what to do if I encounter a zombie?
Yeah, so pretend I'm the zombie. And I happen to be a zombie with a knife.
Yes, what do I do?
So zombie knife, zombie man's coming in with his knife. He's kind of going like that. So first thing you need to do is get up damn way. Exactly, perfect. You've got out the damn way. And now you need to control the weapon. Exactly. So you control the weapon, my force is going that way, so you let me go that way.
Do I pull you as well?
You pull me as well. So I'm off balance now, yeah, and then you can, yeah, hold it with that hand, with the other hand.
Hey.
Hold my wrist with the other hand. That's it. Now this hand is free, and it was down there, so you can just bring your elbow up.
And right, here we are.
And you can also step slightly behind me, like that. And then you're still controlling that wrist, like that. But then you just open up your hand.
Oh, that's a left hand.
Open up, yeah, push, push.
Oh, well, that's good fun.
And I'm down on the ground.
Can I pick you up
down the ground? And now... if the zombie's getting too fruity, then you can just go to town on him. Oh, zombie fighting is hard work. Don't try this at home, kids.
TV Astrocat. So he's the superhero, aren't you, Astrocat? I think so, don't you?
That's good.